So hello, my first question is to please introduce yourself and also give a brief description of the project you're presenting here.
My name's Rachel Perkins, and I'm currently the chair of Equality 2025, which is a cross-government, UK cross-government strategic advisory group on disability issues. But actually what I'm talking about is the work I've been doing for the last 30 years, trying to help people with mental health conditions to get to gain and prosper in employment, and how we moved from those being initiatives within services to actually including them in policy guidance and such like. I think one of the challenges we face in the mental health world is that too often those of us with mental health conditions get stuck in the health service, and people only ever think about our symptoms and our problems. And I guess if we ever get work, it's in segregated, sheltered employment. They sometimes call it training, but it's the sort of training that goes on forever. And the approach that I was pioneering in the late 1990s in England was an approach called individual placement and support, which very much focuses on real jobs and real employment. It tries to pull together clinical treatment and employment support. So you're not treating people, then getting them a job. You're actually doing both at the same time, that you're actually supporting both the individual and their employer. And you can support them without limit of time. So if their condition fluctuates, then you've still got the support there, and also supporting people to progress in their careers. So we started with a program in Southwest London, and it gradually was replicated in other places. We talked a lot to government ministers and officials, and gradually it became, over the last 10 years, included in the guidance that government gives to health services. I think the challenge we face is that each health service can't be told what to do. There is guidance about what is good practice, so it still means that it's very uneven. So in some places they have taken the guidance and done it, in other places maybe they've been a little slower.
Do you see, for international rollout, do you see any obstacles like on this?
I mean, certainly the approach has been examined in research in many places in the world, and certainly a lot of places in Europe, North America, obviously, where it started, Australia, New Zealand, Hong Kong, have all been approaching using this kind of approach. I think the challenge is how we bring together employment services on the one hand and health services on the other, so people don't get stuck in health services with no attention to the rest of their lives. And I think internationally, from my experience, the separation of employment and health poses us all with similar challenges. And of course, in the economic hard times that we face, I have heard people say, well, mad people will be taking jobs that the rest of us should do. I think there is sometimes an assumption that people with mental health conditions come at the bottom of the heap, which is absolutely wrong. And unless we can do this in times of difficulties, we will just see people falling further and further out of our communities.
And my last question is, what's your impression of the Zero Project Conference, and also what would be your wish for the future?
Basically, I'm finding it really exciting hearing about good practice from other countries. I think it's very easy for us to get insular and just look internally. And at the moment, the UK government are developing a disability employment strategy, and I will certainly be taking to that, my advice on that strategy, all the examples of good practice that I see here. So for me, it's a very useful conference and a very useful time to be having that conference.
Perfect. Thank you.